Hey, what's up everybody? It's Stacey Storino. Welcome back to my channel, the number one place for entrepreneurs who want their content marketing to convert content consumers into paying customers. If you've been doing your organic content marketing on Instagram and you're like, what's all of this talk about Instagram SEO? What is it? Why do I care? Does this mean that reels and feed posts aren't important anymore? They are. How can this help me? And or what do I do? Well, you're in luck because Instagram SEO is a thing. You do need to learn it and utilize it. And this video is a great primer from you because from now on, Instagram SEO is going to become increasingly important more and more over time. So let's answer the question then, what is Instagram SEO 2021? But before I forget, make sure to hit that like button and subscribe to get real world help that entrepreneurs like you need to succeed with content marketing that drives traffic to your business so that you can do more business. Okay, let's dive in. Hashtags are still important. Super quick, because I know people are going to ask in the comments section below this video, yes, hashtags on Instagram are still important, and yes, you should still use them. And I did a video on my channel that will really show you how to use your hashtags intelligently, and it's called Blow Up Your Instagram with This Hashtag Strategy. So whatever else I say in this video, you still want to keep utilizing hashtags as part of your content optimization strategy on Instagram. Nothing I say in this video is meant to circumvent or replace any of that. What is Instagram SEO? SEO is an acronym that stands for Search Engine Optimization. You might already be thinking about SEO in terms of getting your website to rank nicely on Google, and you should definitely continue to. But now you have to be more mindful of not just your hashtag optimization on your content, but the keywords that you write in your captions as well. If you weren't writing any captions to go along with your content, or you wrote a sentence or two and that's that, well, those days are over. You need to give the Instagram algorithm more data points so that your content can rank well and properly, and so that every single individual piece of content that you post can be pulled up in search by your ideal customer so that they can find you and your business, even though they didn't know about you, the name of your business, the name of your products, or anything like that. And if you don't understand conceptually about algorithms, really quickly, an AI or artificial intelligence rules the Instagram platform since there's so much content on that platform that no human or team of humans can rule it all, sort it all, etc. by themselves. That AI uses an algorithm, really multiple algorithms, to help it rank things, flag them as spam, index things properly, suggest them out to users who aren't following you yet, like say through the explore page, and more. An algorithm is a mathematical, computational, algebraic formula that can do the work the AI needs it to do. Every hashtag and every keyword serves as data points for the algorithm to weigh and evaluate. Other things serve as data points too. For example, how often someone visits your content and engages with it, saves or shares your content, at mentions you on Instagram, even reaches out to you in the DMs or direct messages to communicate with you privately, and so on. Everything pretty much serves as its own data point to feed into the algorithm so that the goal of the AI is satisfied, and that is to keep Instagram users on the platform longer, so that more ads can be served up to them. It's really that simple. Both keywords and hashtags help keep the AI's algorithm, or algorithms, if you will, to index your content one piece at a time for search on the platform. But now you might be saying to yourself, Instagram is a search engine? It is, and it's being treated like a social search engine, if you will, increasingly so. And that's one of the reasons why the algorithm is now going to take keywords into consideration on an increasing basis when it weighs things out and takes action on the computational scoring of your content, so to speak. People search for content on Instagram on the platform to binge on or consume in batches, having to do with whatever problem they want to solve or whatever desire they want satisfied. So they can search on both keywords keywords and hashtags on the Instagram platform to pull up content that's indexed according to what they're interested in. Now, if you need help in terms of keywords and captions, you're in luck. Why? I just recently did a video entitled Why Your Instagram Captions Don't Work. And if you didn't see that video, make sure you do, because that talks about the importance of using the right types of keywords to get each piece of content of yours pulled up in search by more people more effectively, as well as using the right kinds of keywords or even just words that are related to a call to action in order to get your content consumers to follow you, visit your link in bio, or buy from you, which are, of course, in order, the three macro conversions your business needs to succeed. They'll also likely get you more of the micro conversions that your business needs to succeed in terms of the algorithm pushing your content out to more of your followers more often, as well as suggesting out your content to more people who aren't following you yet, but should be. Micro conversions can include people liking or hearting your content, commenting on it, sharing it, saving it, ad mentioning to you, DMing you, and so on. Suffice it to say, if you don't like to write, you've got two choices if you want to succeed on this platform. One, you learn to get better at it, or two, you delegate copywriting to someone else, and yes, that will cost you some money. No worries, I've got plenty of content on my YouTube channel that can help you to understand how to get more of the conversions your business needs to succeed. So if you're not subscribed yet, please make sure that you do so. Big IG SEO tip. Remember that you have to have a prayer of ranking with your keywords. So not only should you be using ones that will help your content be pulled up in search by an ideal customer of yours who is searching on content to educate, entertain, and/or inspire them in connection with their main pain point or main passion point that would serve as an intersecting interest with a business like yours, but you need to make sure that you have a chance up at ranking towards the top of search instead of being buried in the bottom of the search results. So just like with hashtags, if you go too broad, technically your content will be indexed properly, but no one's likely to get to it because there's so many other pieces of content that are already indexed using those hashtags and are continuously used every single day thereafter. You'll be buried in seconds, for example. Let's say if you're my family's business, Joe's Dairy Barn Grill, and if you use either keywords or hashtags like hamburger, because using hashtags is an easy example. Look, the word hamburger has, let's say, 5.8 million uses already. Come on, how are you ever going to compete there? But if you were to use, let's say, the hashtag jalapeno burger, you'd have, let's say, only 7,300 pieces of content to compete with. Now, in terms of rankability, you can treat hashtags in much the same vein as keywords in your captions. If you can't get traction because you go too broad in terms of your keywords, go for long tail keywords, meaning longer keyword phrases, because you'll likely get more traction faster that way. Now, am I telling you never to use broad or more general or more popular words in your captions? No, because that would be one heck of an impossible caption to write. All I'm saying is that you should be very, very strategic and purposeful about adding more long tail keywords into your caption, because if you are, then you'll be more likely to be found by more people more often. Be just as mindful about keywords as you are about hashtags. And if you want help in terms of figuring out how to get the best traction on Instagram with content optimization, I use and highly recommend a piece of software from Flick.Tech. There's a link in the description below for a free week of it. And yes, Flick.Tech is an official third-party vendor or partner with Instagram, so there's nothing cheesy or risky about using it. It's totally legit. And yes, I'm an affiliate for it. The affiliate disclaimer is in the show notes below too. But I use it, I recommend it to my now thousands of students strong. So although they're not an official sponsor of this video, I'll mention them because if you need help, you should definitely give Flick.Tech a try. And the commission that I might receive from you taking a trial definitely helps to support me making more free training on this very YouTube channel of mine too. It's a win-win. But if you don't rank well, your content won't be found much or very often by the very people you need to make sales with. Whether you use Flick or you don't, optimizing your content to leverage Instagram SEO using both keywords and hashtags is more important than ever before. As the platform gets more users and more users become more savvy about optimization, that Instagram algorithm is going to get more and more complicated over time of necessity. So there's no better time like the present to master social search engine optimization on a platform like Instagram. So there you have it. This is my answer when it comes to the question of what is Instagram SEO. Need more help? Be sure to check out these two awesome videos too, because they'll teach you great content marketing strategies that can also help to blow up your business. Enjoy.